Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back. Welcome to episode 3 of From Grandstreet to Your Street. I got my Grandstreet t-shirt on. Happy Thursday. Hope you're having a good week. This is like 0 to 60, y'all. Like no social media presence whatsoever a couple weeks ago. And now it's like, oh, welcome to my home. Let me show you around. So how about that Matilda video last week? I mean, I already miss my Matilda cast like crazy. And then Kev sends me that finished video. Woo, girl, ga-junk. Like, I have yet to have a quarantine breakdown, and that video may or may not have triggered my first. But it was good. It was good to cry. It's okay. It's okay to cry. If you're feeling sad, if you're feeling anxious, you know, we're gonna go through ups and downs during this crazy time. It's all right. Feel what you gotta feel. Well, believe me, I did. And between that Matilda video and the series finale of Schitt's Creek, which I watched last night, lots of feels. Lots of feels in Jeff's house this week. Hashtag emotions. So for tonight's episode, we are moving to the other side of the dining room. Episode 1, we met Joel Gray. He's right over there on that side of the dining room. But for tonight, we are moving into what I like to think of as my vintage mid-century lounge. I have these two very handsome chairs. Yes, chairs can be handsome. Yes, they can. And I'll prove it to you. Take a look at this. I know, right? Yeah, they look good. They look good up in her. So I always feel kind of cozy and wrapped in a mid-century glow when I sit in these chairs. So this one is Sutton Foster and that one is Gavin Creel. You probably know who Sutton Foster is, and if you don't know who Gavin Creel is, you got some homework to do. Go ahead and give a little Google to Mr. Gavin Creel, and you're welcome. He is delicious in every way possible. So we have some fun new segments planned for tonight, so we're just gonna dive right in, and we're gonna take a look at the very first From Grandstreet to Your Street game show. So, here we go. It is time to play Zoom Heads Up. Hey everybody, what is up? Welcome to our very first game show on From Grandstreet to Your Street. I'm sitting on the floor in my living room, and as you can see right now, we have three mystery homes. So let's introduce our contestants. Our first guest is the one, the only, the beloved director of education at Grand Street Theater. It's Marianne Adams. Marianne, where are you?
Hi! Here I am. I was on the floor.
Oh, this is good. How are you, Marianne?
Thirsty. I gotta get ready for the game.
Oh my God. So give us a quick update, Marianne. How's theater school doing?
Well, you know, we've got some Zoom classes going, and if we can get into the Zoom where it happens. Things are going pretty well. We have a lot of fun and we make a lot of mistakes and then we, you know, start over. And
Making it work.
Nice. Improv.
I like it. Are you ready to play?
Nope. And I'll play.
You're going to play. Great. So Marianne, everybody knows that a good director is
nothing without a good stage manager. So let's introduce our next guest to stage manager superstar. It's Dora Trenbed.
What?
Hi, Dora.
I'm fine.
How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Good. How's quarantine going for you?
Living my best life.
Good. Anything you want to say to the Grandstreet family?
This is a lot of pressure. I don't know. When this is all over and anyone needs a stage manager, give me a call.
Nice. So what's better than one stage manager? Two stage managers. It's our final contestant. It's Rain O'Brien. Hi, Rain.
Hello.
How are you?
You know, I am also thirsty.
I am also thirsty, but I don't have what you guys have. So, team, we are going to play Zoom Heads Up Broadway Edition. So, you're going to be great, Marianne. So, here's how it's going to work. Jeff and Rain are on a team, and Marianne and Dora are on a team. So the catch of this game is obviously Rain and Dora can see themselves. So while they are guessing the clues, they are going to have to close their eyes. Good. Marianne. I feel like this week Marianne is hashtag sweaty. True or false, Marianne? Okay, good. Do you have any questions?
Questions aren't going to help me now.
We're each going to play two rounds, and then we're going to tally those scores to see which team wins. Okay? Team, are we ready to play Heads Up?
Yeah.
We're ready.
Yay!
She was the Dream Girls, the original.
Jennifer Holliday.
Yes. This is Sebastian and Ariel and Flounder.
The Little Mermaid.
Yes. This is Sutton Foster, a little higher, Rain, hold it a little higher. Sutton Foster and, if you're sleepy, another word for sleepy.
The Drowsy Chaperone.
Yes. This is, oh, she's Judy Garland's daughter.
Liza Minnelli.
Yes. In the
Music Man, 76 trombones.
Yes, I'm allowed, Marianne. This is, Bernadette Peters did this in a revival.
And, oh, Sunday in the Park with George.
No, Ethel Merman was the original, like westerny.
Oh, Annie, Get Your Gun.
Yes. She passed away recently, sad. She was the original.
Mary Maisie.
Ladies Who Lunch.
Oh, Elaine Stritch.
Oh!
I think it counted.
It was on the buzzer, not after the buzzer, so I think it counted.
Okay, Rain, what does the phone say?
If we're including Elaine, then it is seven.
Seven, okay, nice.
Three, two, one. Oh, this is, a lot of people mispronounce this, a lot of dancing. Ziegfeld
Follies?
Yes. Oh, this was a terrible movie released recently about meows.
Cats.
Yes. Oh, this is an old-timey, on a ship. It's very culturally inappropriate now.
South Pacific?
You could be.
Showboat?
But, no. not nothing, but.
Oh, Anything Goes.
Yes.
Yes. Ay, Don Quixote, the male. Male. It's another word for male.
Oh my God, I don't know.
Well, like if you munch something, okay, you're passing. Oh, not twice, but I saw this.
Three times?
Oh. Really good.
Three times.
Once would make more sense.
I even sang for you.
You sang well.
Three.
Yeah, three.
Yeah.
We tried three times.
You did try three. Try three times and you got 3 points.
So that was round one of Zoom Heads Up. Stay tuned to future episodes. to catch round two and see who wins the game. I mean, you never know. You never know.
Hi Grandstreet family. Welcome to this week's GST Slideshow.
We hope you like it.
Babushka!
Yeah, that was good.
My job!
I killed myself. Oh, why?
And now for a closer look at what's going on in the Grandstreet family, it's time for GST News. Thank you, Jeff, and welcome to GST News. Grandstreet Theater's programming has moved online, and the building has remained relatively quiet since the middle of March. But some of Grandstreet's volunteers have been busy making masks for the medical community. For more on that story, we go now to special correspondent, Costumer Karen.
Hi, Costumer Karen here. Thought I would share some thoughts about what's going on in the costume side of Grandstreet. This is my studio, also known as the second bedroom, and those are my machines. Not busy doing any costumes right now. Sorry, Jeff. So some of us costumers and set workers are sewing fabric masks to give to the medical community to help extend their use of their official masks by putting these fabric masks over them. I'm using some of my remnants from some of my past costume making from Book of Will. The quality of mercy is unstrained. Sense and sensibility. I'm Miss Dashwood and I need a husband. No, I'm Miss Dashwood and I need a husband. I guess they're from Southern England. Charlie Brown Christmas. Charlie Brown's little sister Sally, her dress before I drew all the little dots, little black dots all over her dress. Les Mis. One more day, or week, or two, or three, we can get through this. We wash our hands, practice social distancing, wear a mask out in public if we have to go to the grocery store. We can do this. Let's stick together. Love you guys. Stay well.
Other members of the Grandstreet community have been pitching in as well. Stefan Razel and Terrell Hibbard at Gulch Distillers have been using their business to make hand sanitizer. Stefan, tell us more.
Hello, it's Stefan, your favorite local distiller. I just wanted to give you a quick update about what we are doing down at Gulch Distillers to help out in this crazy time we're in right now. we have switched over to making hand sanitizer, and we're cranking it out as fast as we possibly can. We've teamed up with a lot of great partners around the community to kind of expedite that process. Our first few batches have gone straight to the hospital and first responders, and hopefully in the next week, we'll have it available to the public. So just keep an eye out. Check out our Facebook page and we'll let you know when that's available. You can also come down to the tasting room where we are offering curbside delivery so you can pick up a bottle and make that quarantini at home. And just enjoy a nice drink at home with your family and just try to enjoy this time and forget about how crazy things are out there. I hope everyone's doing well and staying safe, and I look forward to seeing you all very soon.
Ladies and gentlemen, this just in, breaking news, Owen Felber's training wheels have come off. I repeat, ladies and gentlemen, Owen Felber is riding his bike without training wheels. Congratulations, Owen. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, good things are still happening in the world. Luckily, the Easter Bunny was still deemed an essential worker and visited millions of children's homes, hiding eggs and leaving presents for Easter morning. For more on that story, we go to our special correspondent, my niece, Ren.
It's really hot.
How did that get up there?
Maybe you need to reach it up because you are big.
Who do you think put it up there?
I don't know.
Oh, who put it up there?
Somebody.
How did he get up there?
I don't know.
Maybe he hopped up there.
Hopped up there? Yes, he was inside.
Yeah. See what's inside.
I need a basket.
Get that girl a basket. She needs those eggs tidy and organized. That's a girl after my own heart. I have also been noticing, as I run around the neighborhood, more and more sidewalk chalk with positive messages. For more on that story, we go out onto the street with a closer look. Take a look at this.
Wear a mask. We have the best neighbors. Enjoy life. We are all one human family. I love this one up here. Look at this. Call your mom and grandmother. Make the best of life. Wash your hands. Here's another one I found. Smile. It's a lovely day.
Look, I found some more. Got a little flower, a little sunshine. A little apple tree. What's this? You're awesome. Oh, that's not how you spell your, you guys. If only I had some chalk, I could just add an apostrophe R. You know what? It's a thought that counts. Thought that counts. Good job. Good job, guys.
That's the news for tonight. Back to you, Jeff. You know what the top hat means? Time for some more music and another round of 32 Bar Cabarets. And yes, I know, episode one, some of the songs, the cuts were a little bit longer than 32 bars. I know. I have a friend, a very good friend actually, who likes to text me when she watches these episodes, and she was sending me these texts. That was great, but it was longer than 32 bars. Oh my God, love her, but more than 30. Yes, I know, and to protect her anonymity, I will not say her name, but it may or may not rhyme with Shmia Smavello. So our first singers tonight are a lovely husband and wife team. So happy to see them performing together. Please help me welcome Jack and Jody Isbell.
Tell me
what's ailing me.
She said,
yeah, yeah, yeah.
Good luck.
You have just auditioned for me, so look out. I'm going to be coming for you. Our next guest is such a wonderful singer. I was lucky enough to get to work with her while she was a theater school student, and now she's all grown up and she's a mom, and we are so happy to have her on our show. Please welcome Selena Leboutillier? Selena, I don't know. It's hard to say. Selena English is who we got. Selena Leboutillier.
This is my street. I smile at the faces I've known all my life. They regard me with pride, and everyone's sweet. They say you're going places, so how can I say that while I was away, I had so much to hide? Hey guys, it's me. The biggest disappointment, you know. The kid couldn't hack it. She's back, and she's walking real slow. Welcome home, just breathe. Just breathe. Love you all so much.
Brava! So nice, Selena. Thank you. And what a lovely reminder that sometimes we just need to pause and breathe. Take a nice deep breath. We're gonna be okay. Our final performance tonight comes from two very talented performers who I have been lucky enough to work with several times over the years at Grandstreet. Love working with them, love singing with them. I miss them. They're in New York, so I'm so happy that they sent in this video for us tonight. Please help me welcome Kurt Crowley and Sarah Yeakel.
Forget your trouble.
Happy days.
Come on, get happy. You'd better
the
chase all your cares.
Clear again.
Shout hallelujah.
So let's sing a song of cheer.
Come on, get happy
again.
Get ready.
Happy days
for the
are here again.
That sun is shining. Come on,
shout it now.
The Lord
there's
is waiting
no one
to
who
take
can
your
doubt it now.
Shout hallelujah.
Just days on the face of the soul clear.
happy nights, happy days are here again.
That's our show for tonight. Thank you guys so much for watching. We will see you next week. Mwah, mwah, mwah. Stay strong. Stay safe. Bye. You are ruining it for the rest of us. Hey! 6 feet! I give up.